H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Which will give you a good confidence level saying like, okay, I have developed some application. Okay, so now let me try to do that. So here, what I'm doing here is console.writeline. I'm giving some stars, a lot of stars here. Okay, so after that, what I'll do is let me run this and see how it looks like. Is it crossing the line? Yeah, it is crossing the line. So I don't need to give this many stars. So let me put this one. Okay, let me run this. So yeah, okay, this is fine. So what I need to do is I'll write here, see now, try to understand, console.writeline. Welcome to quiz program. Welcome to quiz program. And then I'll copy this. Okay, so I have written welcome to quiz program, and then I need I'll just give 5 questions. Okay, so 5 questions, 100 marks. What is the score for each question? 5 questions, 100 marks. So per question, how many marks? Yeah, good. All of you are good in mathematics. Okay, so just kidding. Okay, so now let me add first question. So console.writeline Q1 question 1. Question 1 dot capital of Tamil Nadu. I think all of you from India only, except Jesse. Okay, so for the benefit of Jesse, I'll change the question. So what we can add here? Okay, chemical formula for water. Okay, so I just gave here 1 question. So now I'm displaying here console.writeline. I'm going to display the options. First one, H3O, and then the second option which we have is H2O, and then we have the third option CH4, which is methane, and the fourth option, let me give none of this. Okay, so here, okay, so I have added a question, chemical formula for water. So any idea what is the answer? Okay, good, some of you are still remembering. So the answer is H2O. So now, so like this, you thought of conducting a small quiz for your kid. So let me copy the same question, and then here I need to give console.writeline your option. Okay, and we will ask, enter your option. So here we have to tell enter your option. So now you have to read the option whatever they enter into the answer. So I need 5 answers. So int answer. So int answer, and then I need score also. Score is equal to, first let me put 0. Score equal to 0, and here I need to read the name also. So string name. So I want to read the name. So welcome to quiz program. The first thing I'll ask the person is console.writeline, enter your name. Okay, and here I'll write here how to read the name. Name is equal to, I want to read. How to read this? What I need to write here? what I need to write here to read the name? Yeah, Bobby, you're right. Yeah, Seema, you're right. So I need to write console.readline. Okay, so let me ask this question before starting. So Control C, Control X, and I'll put here. And then here I'll put here dear, and then I'll put here flower brackets, comma, welcome to quiz program, and then I can put here comma name. Okay, so now you just read the name and you are writing here dear Meghnad or whatever, welcome to quiz program, and then you are giving questions here. So now if the answer is 2, then what I need to do? So I need to write here. So how to read here answer is equal to how to read this value? What I need to write here if I want to read the answer whatever user enters? I need to write here, I cannot write straight away console.readline. I need to write convert.toint, and then I need to write here console.readline. Okay, since console.readline is a string, if I want to store it into this answer, I have to write convert.toint. Okay, then I have to write if answer is equal to, if answer is equal to 2, then I have to increase by my score by how much? I have total 5 questions, so I have to increase the score by how much? Add 20 to the score. So score plus 20. Please tell me if you're not getting. If you do this project, even I'll be really happy. Just you will understand, like you will feel some confidence. In the 3 classes itself, I'm doing a simple quiz application in .NET. So that will bring confidence. That will make me happy if you are doing this application. Okay, so now let me copy paste the same question. I'm not going to waste time here. So but you have to create now I'm going to add here. So now I have 5 questions here. So question 1, I change it to question 2, I change it to question 3, I change it to question 4, I'll change it to question 5. Okay, so now what I'll write here is last one. So if score greater than 60, so 60 is the pass mark, assume that greater than 60 is the pass mark. So if score greater than 60, you have to display console.writeline congratulations person D comma use code 0. So you have to put 1, and then you have to put comma. First place, I want to put the name of the person. So congratulations, name of the person. So here I need to write name, comma, and in this place I have to put the score. So here I'm writing score. Okay, so else, we don't want to disappoint. Console.writeline, you have to put sorry. Same thing. So sorry, use code only this much, please try again. Okay, and you can give name comma score. Okay, so now done with this. So now let's try to run this and see the magic. So now I'm done with a small quiz application, but I have the same questions all the places, but still you can try with. So now what I can do is, so in C#, when I'm doing in Notepad, when I compile it, it used to create an exe file. So similarly, when I rebuild it in Visual Studio, you need to rebuild like this. So you need to go to Solution Explorer. If you're not seeing this, you have to click on View and you have to click on Solution Explorer. So you will see the Solution Explorer. You need to right click on this. You need to rebuild the solution. So when you rebuild it, it will compile your complete code. So I need to rebuild the solution. And then you can see that exe file. So where is my exe file? You can see that you need to right click on program.cs. I repeat again, you need to right click on program.cs, open containing folder. You need to type open containing folder. I repeat again, right click on this program.cs tab, open containing folder. Inside that you will see something called bin debug. Inside that debug you will see that exe file. Copy the exe file, put it on the desktop, and then ask some of your family members saying like, okay, I have done this application, can you please try this? So here you can rename this to quiz.exe. Okay, so now double click on it. So it is telling, enter your name. I'll enter Meghnad. So dear Meghnad, welcome to quiz program. So here I'm entering answer. I know the answer 2, second question 2, third question 2, fourth question I'll give some wrong answer, fifth question I'll give 2. I don't want to get sorry, so I'll get congratulations. So see now, congratulations Meghnad, you scored 80%. You scored 80. You can add percent there, and you can add one more line there, so just to make it better. So what you can do here is before this, the last question you can copy this again. So I need this is the last question, right? So here I can give like this, I can put like this, and I can put use code. I need to give percentage. Okay, so this will look better. So let me run this. So let me rebuild it again. So save all and then rebuild it. Every time I need to rebuild, I need to take the exe file again. So I need to right click on this program.cs, open containing folder. I need to go to bin folder inside debug. I'll have exe file, copy this, right click on this, copy this, go to desktop, and then remove this old version, delete this. So since I have opened it, it's not allowing me, so let me close it, delete it. Now paste the new one, paste it, and then rename it to quiz. Okay, so now you don't need to rename, but since they will understand like this, the quiz application which you have written, and then you need to double click on it. So enter your name, Meghnad. So I'm going to enter all correct now. Two, second option. So you can see that, congratulations, Meghnad, you scored 100%. So this is how you can create a small application, quiz application. You can start giving this to your kids or someone in your family, so that you can tell them that I have created this. So this will score. So how many of you give it a try in the home and ask your okay. So how many of you will do that? Yeah. So okay. So anyway, you will tell to me you will do that. But please, it's a request from my side. Please do it so that even they will feel like okay. Please try it. Okay. So in case if you have any question here, can you please ask me if you want me to explain this again? Or is it clear for all of you? Is it clear for all of you? There is nothing in this. I only have if condition. I only have reading the answer. So very simple, very simple. So you can easily do it. So this is for decoration. Here I have given stars. I have given dear. So I'm reading the name here. I'm putting in 0 here. Welcome to quiz program. So all these things. Okay. So the assignment for today will be, you have to send this code to me. You have to send this quiz code to me. Maybe you don't need to send the exe file to me, because if you send the exe file, Gmail will filter it, assuming that it's a virus or something. So you can send this, copy this, Control A, and then right click on this, and then copy this, and then Windows R, Notepad, you can paste it, and you can send me that. Okay, so questions of your choice, whatever you are giving for your family, I mean simple questions, you can actually send to me. That is the assignment for today. Okay, now any questions so far? Any questions, or if it's clear, you can mention it's clear. Okay, so I got one question saying like for alternative way for this is, see, the use of this one, console.writeline, sorry, so in this zero place it will print name, and in this one place it will print score. So if you want to have alternative for it, yeah, definitely we have alternative, but that will be like this. So you had to write like this, and you had to like write here, sorry, name. So and then here you had to put again double quotes. This will be a bit confusing, so I always prefer, so I can write here score, and I don't need to write this. Okay, so this is one way. So you can write sorry followed by double quotes. You are closing it here, and you are adding plus name, again plus, you are adding use code only, again plus, you are writing score here, and then plus, you're writing please try again. So if I run this, now you can see I'll give wrong answers. So let me give Ravi. So I'll give all ones. Sorry Ravi, you scored only 0%. Please try again. So this is how you can give. So you can either way. So I'm comfortable reading this way. So hope you are also comfortable with this way. So if you don't want to have 0, 1 like that, you can actually write you can actually append it, plus you scored, plus you can do like this. Okay so please try this. Please send me the code for your quiz which I have taken for your some of your family members, so that will bring confidence level. Okay so we'll take a short break for 5 minutes and then we'll come back. Okay, so it is 6:32 my time, so we'll meet in exactly 5 minutes. Okay, so okay, so now we are good with control structure. I mean, we are good with using if condition, if else, else if. So now we have switch case, we have loops. So now before going to switch case, we'll learn about loops. Okay, so now I'll just save it. So I hope all of you are there, so no one went for a break. Okay so now I'll minimize it. I'll open again Visual Studio, all new program, Microsoft Visual Studio. So now I will explain you what is how to use a for loop or what is the use of loops. Okay, so I'm going to create file, new project. I repeat again, file, new project. I'm going to select console application and first select Visual C Sharp and then select console application. Click on OK. Okay, so now so every time we normally do a new project and then I'll select console application. So now here I need to write console dot write line, console dot write line. Hello. Okay. Now. Okay, this one. So I got a question saying like, what is this references? So I'm getting a question from Bhavik saying, what is the zero references? What is the zero references? Okay, I'll tell that. I'll tell that in the later stages. I'll tell. For now, if you are using Visual Studio 2012 or 2008 or 2010, you'll not see this. Only in 2013 they added this. This is very good feature. So anyway, I'll tell this later. For now, forget about this. Okay. Yeah. So I'm writing here console.writeline hello. Console.writeline hello. So I want to print hello 5 times. How can I do that? I want to print hello 5 times. So do I need to write console.writeline hello 5 times? Yeah. So all of you know the answer, then I don't need to tell loops actually. So all of you know that. So you're telling that we need to use a for loop. Okay, so yes, we have to use a loop. So loops are used for repetitive tasks. So if you want to do the same task repetitively, so we normally go for using loops. Okay, so now let's try to learn a simple loop here. So I have prepared a PPT for that, so let me open that. The only difference is you will see printf there instead of console.writeline. Don't worry, I'm actually preparing a material for C Sharp as well. I'll come up by Saturday Sunday. I'll work on it and then I'll come with PPT for C Sharp. So for now I'm going to open this for loop. Okay, so here you will see don't worry, you're seeing printf here instead of this. You need to assume that it's console.writeline here. So what if I have a requirement to print hello 5 times? So you don't okay, you'll add 5 times, but what if you have to print 100 times? Do you write 100 times printf or 100 times console.writeline? It's not required. So it is not required. So we have alternative. We need simple way to iterate the same functionality, and loops will help us here. So loops will help us here. So this is the general syntax for for loop. So for So this is the general syntax for initialization and then limit condition and then increment or decrement. So initialization is like I is equal to 1. For I is equal to 1, I less than or equal to 5, I plus plus. So this is how your simple for loop will look like. For I is equal to 1, this is called initialization, and then condition I less than or equal to 5 and then I plus plus. Okay, this is how your for loop will work like. Inside this you need to write console dot write line, you need to write here hello. Okay, so you need to write like this. Okay, so now let me explain how it happens. So first it'll initialize and then it'll check for the condition, and then inside statements will be executed. Initialization followed by the condition, whether the number is less than or equal to 5 or something, then statements will be executed. After the statements are executed, it will go and increment the value. So it will go this way and increment it I plus plus, and then again it will check for the condition. So this is how it executes. So initialization will happen only once. I repeat again, first initialization happens and then it will check for the condition. After checking the condition, the statements are executed. Once the statements are executed, it will go for increment or decrement, and then again it will check for the condition. Okay, so let me explain with a simple program, simple example. So here I want to print hello 5 times. So what I'll do here, I will be writing here a for loop for int I is equal to 1, I less than or equal to 5, I plus plus. Okay, and here I'm writing here console.writeline, I have to write I need to write hello. Okay, so this is the general syntax for for loop. I'm just zooming it a bit. So now first what happens is I is equal to 1 will happen. So after that this statement will execute, and then it will happen I plus plus. I plus plus means that will become 2. 2 less than or equal to 5, yes, write hello. 3 less than or equal to 5, yes, write hello. 4 less than or equal to 5, write hello. And I value becomes 5. 5 less than or equal to 5, yes, that is true. It will print hello. Again I plus plus, it becomes 6. So when it becomes 6, 6 less than or equal to 5, which is not satisfied, it will stop. So if I run this, you can see that, okay, why I'm not able to see the output. What I need to do here, it is printing and getting disappeared. What I need to do here, if I want to see the output, I have to add console.readline. Okay, let me run this. So here I can see that hello is printed 5 times. So that is the use of for loop. Okay, I went for an interview. So what happened there was, I went for an interview, that guy gave me pen and paper. So there he just gave me, he wrote like this. I got surprised. He wrote like this control X, and he wrote here, and then he wrote here I plus plus, and he asked me what is output. You would have never seen that, so I thought of sharing this experience with you. So in for loop, he wrote console.writeline. I don't know why he wrote, but he just asked me what is the output for this. I said it will give compilation error, because so far I was thinking like in for loop, you need to have I is equal to 1, I less than or equal to 5, I plus plus, and then you need to write I plus plus. But strangely, when I came home and just tried this, it is not giving any error. It is giving the output, proper output. See now when I run this, it is printing hello 5 times. Okay, so I'm not going to explain this. Give it a try to understand this. So now what I will say here is, inside a for loop, it is not necessary that you always should have this syntax. This is just the general syntax for for loop. But all these three are statements. This is a statement, this is a statement, and then this is a statement. So now what happens here is, you should know the flow actually. So first this will happen, then this will check, then this will come inside, then this will be printed. So now what happens here is, let me run this and see the output. Output is hello 5 times. So it'll work. So now let me try to explain this. Okay. So now, yeah, you're right, Bobby. Yeah. So now, first initialization happens, and then first it will happen here, and it will come here, and then it will come here. So I value will become 2. First time I value becomes 2, nothing, no statements are here. So after this, it will come here. So it will print hello. So hello is printed once. Okay. So now it will check for the condition. So what is it? 2 less than or equal to 5. Okay. So now it will come here. I value becomes 3. It will print hello second time. Okay. So now it will come here again. So 3 less than or equal to 3 less than or equal to 5. Now I value becomes 4 and it will print hello. Now 4 less than or equal to 5. 4 less than or equal to 5. It will come inside. I value becomes 5. It will print hello. Now 5 less than or equal to 5. Yes, 5 less than or equal to 5. It will come inside. I value becomes 6. And it will come here. It will print hello. Now 6 less than or equal to 5. Not satisfied. It will come outside. So it will print hello 5 times. So you have to keep it in mind that first initialization, first this will be executed, then this will be executed, and this will come inside, and then this will go here. So if someone asks you in any interview what is the output for this, don't tell it's a compilation error. It's not a compilation error. You will get the output. So is it clear? Please ping if it's clear, or else I'll explain again. Is it clear now? Yeah. Okay, good. Okay, so this is about writing for loop. Now we have something similar to for loop, which is while loop. So while loop is also used to repeatedly do the things. So now let me tell you how to use a while loop. So while loop is also very much similar. The only difference is you will put this initialization before while loop. So I need to write like this. So int I is equal to 1 while I less than or equal to 5. I'll write here console.writeline hello, and then I'll write here i++. Okay, so this is very much same. The only difference is I'm putting initialization I equal to 1 here, and then I'm writing this condition here I less than or equal to 5, and then I'm writing console.writeline hello, and I'm just printing i++. Okay, so first time I value is 1, 1 less than or equal to 5, hello will be printed again, i++ it will become 2. 2 less than or equal to 5, hello will be printed, it will become 3. 3 less than or equal to 5, hello will be printed, it will become 4. 4 less than or equal to 5, hello will be printed, and it will become 5. 5 less than or equal to 5, hello will be printed, it will become 6. When it becomes 6, 6 less than or equal to 5, the condition will fail, and it will come outside, it will stop there. So, there is no confusion here, it is very much same, the only difference is I is equal to i+1. The common mistakes which I... No, let me run this and see the output. I'm seeing the output as hello. The common mistakes which I see with a lot of students when they're using while loop is they forget this i++. So what happens when you forget this i++? Can someone tell me what happens if I forget i++? How many times this hello will be printed if I forget i++? No, it will not print one time. First time, what happens to I value? I value is 1. So it will print I less than or equal to 5. So 1 less than or equal to 5, it will print hello. Again, it will check 1 less than or equal to 5, hello. 1 less than or equal to 5, hello. 1 less than or equal to 5, hello. So always I value is 1. So it will keep on printing. So it will never stop. So if you forget to put i++, this will become an infinite loop. So run this. See what happens. See now, just keep on printing. After some time, your system will hang. So better stop it. So you must ensure that you're putting this increment or decrement. Otherwise, what happens? What happens to while loop? It will become an infinite loop. So let me open the PPT which I have for while loop. Okay, so let me show this while loop. So while loop is also used for iterative tasks similar to for loop. This is the general syntax. So the statements inside while loop will be executed until the condition is satisfied. So So here, this is the general syntax. Forget about printf. Assume that it's a scanf, and forget about include stdio.h. It is so it is using system. It's good, right? So you're learning even C programming. You only paid for .NET, right? Just kidding. So I'll change this PPT. So now, important, not having this i equal to i plus 1 will result in infinite loop. If you forget this statement, this will result in infinite loop. Okay, so that is about while loop. So is it clear about while loop? Okay, so now, okay, good. So now, in the last class, while explaining about operators, I have not told one operator. I asked one of the student to explain in the next class. Can you guys recollect what is that operator I have not covered? Good, you guys remember. Good. So now I'll make ZOR. I have not explained, but still I have added this in the assignment. I got answers from all of you. Thank you very much. So so now I'll make Sandhya as presenter. She'll be explaining us what is a ZOR operator. You guys try to understand. And before going to that, I just want to ask you, can someone take do while? So we have something called do while. So who can take it in the next class? What is the use of do while statement? Something similar to while loop, we have do while. So who wants to take it up? Okay, no, Sandhya, as you are explaining today about ZOR, so I want to give chance for someone else. So who wants to take it up? Someone should explain what is the use of do while. Very simple. I'll be there anyway to help if you're stuck somewhere. So I'll give 10 minutes time, so you have to explain. So this way everyone will get chance. So who wants to take it up, do while? People should come up. You are going to work for a software company, so you should be bold enough to come and try to represent yourself. Who wants to take it up? You have 2 days time. Even tomorrow we don't have. Okay, so Seema wants to take it up. Thank you very much, Seema. So you can take time today and tomorrow to prepare on do while statement, and you can explain. I'll make 10 minutes presenter for you in the next class. You can explain a do while statement. Okay, so now I'm making Sandhya as presenter, so she'll be explaining us bitwise ZOR. So Sandhya, I made you as presenter, so you have to unmute yourself and then you have to share your screen. I will unmute you just a second. Yeah, I just unmuted you, so we can hear you. You can speak something so that we can hear.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we are able to hear you. Yeah. So
hello everyone.
Just a second. Yeah. So all of you, until you are clear, you can keep on asking questions to Sandhya. Ask as many questions as possible until you are clear on this bitwise ZOR operator. Okay. Yeah. Sandhya, go ahead.
Yeah. Hello everyone, I'm Sandhya. Today I'm going to discuss with you about XOR operator. So as you see, XOR operator stands for exclusive OR. XOR means it's exclusive OR, and it is represented by the symbol inverted V, which is known as a caret symbol. It is called as a caret symbol. So let me tell you how XOR works. When XOR operation is applied between two operands, the operation returns true only if exactly one of its operand is true but not both. Now you have to understand the definition clearly, but let me explain you about the definition in the truth table below here. Am I going a bit clear or is it okay?
Yeah, I'm getting it. This is a perfect definition.
Okay. So let me tell you about the truth table to explain the definition correctly. So I have taken here two operands, X and Y, and the third column provides you the XOR operation between X and Y. So when in the first case, when X is 0 and when Y is 0, the resulting XOR operation is 0. it clear when both values are zero, obviously the resulting operation will be zero for anything. So in the second case, the first operand is zero and the second operand is one. Here you should note that exactly one operand is true and the other one is false. So according to this definition, the resulting XOR operation is also true. In the third case again, X is true and Y is false. Here also exactly one operand is true and the other is false. So the resulting XOR between X and Y is also true. But in the last case, though both X and Y, both are true, but still the resulting XOR operation is zero, because according to the definition, exactly one operand should be true but not both of them. So this is the way how XOR works. Is this clear till now?
So all of you can respond in the chat window to Sandhya. If you have any questions, please ask her.
So all of you
can respond to Sandhya. For me it's perfectly clear. You can continue. This is very good.
And I would like to take some more time to explain the difference between bitwise OR and XOR. As you know, both are very much similar and they only differ in one case. So you should not really get confused between both of them. So I'm just taking some time to explain the difference between them.
Okay.
It's like if you look at the truth table, this is the truth table for OR and this is the truth table for XOR. So if you look at both of them, these both are similar in the first three cases. This case and this case, the output is similar in both the tables. But when you see in the last one, in the OR operation, when X is 1 and Y is 1, the resulting XOR is also 1. But in XOR, when both are true, the resulting result is 0. So that is why OR is called as inclusive OR, because either of them is one, the result is true. But whereas in XOR, it should be explicitly stated that only one operand should be true, but not both of them. So this is the major difference between OR and XOR. So please don't get confused between these two. And lastly, let me just take an example and explain XOR between two numbers. So I'm taking 12 XOR 10. So 12, when converted into binary, it will be 1100, and 10, when it is converted into binary, it will be 1010. So when you do XOR between these two numbers, so 010 is 0, 011 is 1, because exactly one operand is 1. And here 1 and 0 is again 1, because only one operand is 1. And the last one, 1 and 1 is 0, because both operands are 1. According to XOR, when both are 1, the result is 0. So 0, 1, 1, 0 in decimal is 6. So when XOR is performed between 12 and 10, the result is 6. And I have taken one more example, 20 and 30. Just let me know if you can understand this. I'll just not explain this, otherwise I'll explain this also.
Yeah. This is the perfect explanation which I have seen from all the students till now. I have asked some other students in my previous batch also, but this is the perfect explanation. For me, this is perfectly clear. Others, please ask questions if you have to Sandhya.
Please let me know if this is clear for everyone.
Yeah, actually, Sandhya, I'm getting the ping from them saying it's very clear. So,
okay.
Yeah, thank you very much. So, all of you, do you have any questions to Sandhya? Okay. So, yeah, this is very good explanation. Thank you very much, Sandhya. So, I can see very good teacher in you. So, anyway, yeah, thank you very much. Yeah. Okay. So I'll take the presenter access. So maybe you can send this PDF to me. I'll share with all of you, all the students.
Yeah.
Okay. So that is about XOR operator. Big thanks to Sandhya. So we are done with the data types. We are done with operators. We are done with some of the control structures. So we discussed about for loop, we discussed about while loop and do while loop. In the next class, Seema is going to explain us, and we saw about if else condition. So now we have something called conditional operator. So let's try to understand what is a conditional operator. So let me show my screen again. I'll click on share my desktop, just a second. I'm not able to share my desktop. Yeah. Okay, so now I'll be explaining what is a conditional operator. So let me explain. So now, okay, so I want to check whether the number is even or odd. So what I'll do is I'll put string result. Okay, I have string result, and I'll have int n is equal to 5. So now what I'll do here is result is equal to, I can write like this, if n modulo 2 is equal to, sorry, I need to write here n. Why I'm not seeing n here? Just a second. Yeah. So I have declared n modulo 2 is equal to 0. Question mark, I'm typing here even, and then colon, I'm typing here odd. Okay. So writing like this, we call it as, I hope you are able to hear me. So here, if I don't have this conditional operator, I should have written like this. For example, I should have written like this. So if n modulo 2 is equal to 0, I should have written like this. Result is equal to even. And then I need to write else. I need to write result. Result is equal to odd. Okay. So I should have written like this. If n modulo 2 equal to 0, I should have written result equal to even, else result equal to odd. So instead of this, this is called conditional operator. So conditional operator will have a question mark and a colon, question mark and a colon. So after this condition, you will have a question mark. And then if this condition is true, this will be assigned to this result. If the condition is false, after colon, whatever you have, that will be assigned to this result. So now in this case, I don't need to write this four lines. Instead of this four lines, I can simply write two lines. See, now I just commented it. So instead of this four lines, I just wrote only one line. Okay. So now what I can write here, I can write console.WriteLine. I can write result. So that is the benefit of using a conditional operator. So the general syntax for conditional operator is condition, question mark, if it becomes true, this will assign to this, if it becomes false, this will assign to this. Okay, so, or if you want this to be in the single line, you can even write like this. N modulo 2, so I can write like this here, n modulo 2 is equal to 0, you can write question mark, console.WriteLine, write even, and then colon, console.WriteLine, can write odd. Okay, just a second, I'm getting a call. Just a second. Hello. Swati, can you call me in 10 minutes? I'm about to complete a class. Yeah, I have your number. I'll call you back. Okay, so this is about using conditional operators. So I can just put a semicolon here. So now this line will throw error because I'm not assigning this value anywhere. So when you're using conditional operator, you have to assign this to some result, so like this. Okay, so even this should work. I'll try to correct it. But is it clear now? Here I'm using conditional operator. So now when I execute this, what will be the output now when I execute this? since I have given n value as 5, so 5 modulo 2 is 1, so this will become odd numbers, so the result will be odd. So when I run this, see the output, the result is odd number. Okay, so this is about conditional operator. So if the condition is true, the statement after question mark will be assigned to this result. If the condition is false, the statements after colon will be assigned to the result. Okay, so I'll quickly summarize what we have discussed today. We just discussed on all the topics which we covered so far in the previous classes, and then we discussed on for loop, and we discussed on if else and else if condition. We also discussed on how to read the number from the user, how to read the values from the user. We saw that convert.toIn32 and convert.toIn16 and console.readline, and we also did a small quiz application which you can actually do and to display the result, to display the score of the persons who attended the quiz. And then we saw what is the use of for loop and while loop, and we saw if we forget increment operation, we just notice that it will become an infinite loop. And then we saw a conditional operator, and we got very good explanation on bitwise XOR operator from Sandhya. So and in the next class we'll try to understand switch case, and then we'll move to the next other topics. Okay, and Seema will be explaining us what is a do while statement. Okay, thank you very much. Thanks for joining. Thanks to Sandhya. So any questions you have for today? Okay, I'll be sending the assignment. Anyway, you know the assignment. Even if you don't get assignment from me, you already know the assignment. What is the assignment? Assignment for today? Yeah, you have to send me the quiz application. Even if you didn't get, I normally send a PDF document. Even if you don't get the PDF document, you have to send me the quiz application which you have conducted. I'll just compile it, and then I'll copy paste your code in Visual Studio. I'll compile it. I should not get any errors. Okay. Thank you very much. Thanks for joining. Good night.
Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.